students, a very warm good morning to all of you and welcome back in our biology session. So in our biology session we are discussing our lesson and the name of the lesson is what? Reaching the age of adolescence. Okay, so in this lesson already we have discussed some points and now we will move on the next point from the same lesson, that is today we will discuss about role of hormones in initiating reproductive functions. Okay, so role of the hormones, as we know in our previous lecture we have discussed about the hormones. So the hormones are the chemical messenger which brings the so many changes in our body or on sets of puberty. During the puberty so many changes occurs in our body that all the changes takes place because of these hormones. Okay, so these hormones are the chemical substance which are secreted by the different glands, or we can say that what, these are the substances which are secreted by the endocrine gland, which are also called as what, ductless glands. Okay, so these hormones brings the, or these hormones are taking the initiating these reproductive functions. Okay, so let's see, as we know there are the endocrine glands are present in our body and the glands are also called as what, ductless gland. So that endocrine gland or the ductless gland release their secretion, that is nothing but what, hormones into the bloodstream. Okay, into the bloodstream they are releases their secretion and with the help of their bloodstream that hormones reach to their particular body part or particular body organ, and that body part or that body organ is called as what, target site. Okay, it's called as what, target site, is where it necessary, where it need to say it reach there, and where it reach that part is called as what, target site. Okay, so in this way the endocrine gland or the ductless gland release their secretion into the bloodstream and with the help of the blood it reaches to their body parts or their particular body organ, and that part is called as what, target site. Okay, so as we know there are the different hormones are secreted in our body. So on the set of the puberty, once the puberty started and there so many changes takes place in our body started to secrete different hormones which helps to make the body ready for the reproductions. Okay, so because of these hormones so many secondary sexual character takes place in our body that we have already seen in our previous video. Okay, and also these hormones helps to mature. Because of these hormones the testes in the male and the ovaries in the females are getting mature and they started to release the male and the female sex gamete. Okay, so as we know in the male the sex gamete is what, sperm, while in the female the sex gamete is what, ova or the eggs. Okay, so in this way because of these hormones these testes or the ovaries are getting mature. But as we know these hormones are under the control of the hormones which are secreted by the pituitary glands. Okay, so all these sex hormones are under the control of the another hormone which is secreted by the pituitary glands. Okay, so many hormones are secreted by the pituitary gland. Among one of the hormones, because one of the hormones the testes in the males are get mature and started to secrete the female sex hormone, that is what, testosterone. And because one of the hormones which are secreted from the pituitary gland, because of that hormones the ovaries in the females are getting mature and started to release the female sex hormone, that is what, estrogen. Okay, so let's see how it exactly takes place. So hormones from pituitary stimulate testes and ovaries to release the testosterone in male. Testosterone is what, male sex hormone. Why? Because of the hormones from the pituitary in the female they are also getting mature, the ovaries are also getting mature and ovaries started to secrete the female sex hormone, that is what, estrogen in female. Okay, so these ovaries started to secrete the estrogen in female. In the male testes get mature and started to release the testosterone. Why this happens? Because of the hormones which are secreted from the pituitary gland. Okay, Next one we will see that these all released in the bloodstream and reach part of the body. Okay, so these secretions get mixed into the bloodstreams and reach part of the body, and that part of the body is called as what? Target site. Okay, and once it reaches that target site, it started to stimulate the change in the body at onset of puberty. Okay, so when these secretions reaches to the target site, then it started to bring the certain changes in that particular body part, and therefore that only we are calling as what? Onset of puberty. Okay, they stimulate the changes in the body at onset of puberty. Okay, so in this way, these are the hormones which plays a vital role in the changes of the body during the puberty. Okay, so this is about what role of hormones in initiating reproductive functions. Now we'll move for the next point, that is about reproductive phase of life in humans. Okay, so as we know, from the age or during the adolescence period, certain changes started to occur. Our body slowly get mature for the reproduction. But how much longer it will remain, or how much longer our body is capable for the reproduction? So let's find out the answer for this question. So generally in the female, they are ready for the reproduction, or their reproductive phase begins at the puberty or during the age at 10 to 12 years. Okay, 10 to 12 years. Okay, so as we know, we are discussing in our some previous sections that females are getting more mature. As a if we talk about the reproduction, or if we talk about the onset of the puberty, their girls are getting mature so earlier than the boys. Okay, so their puberty period starts at the age of the 10 to 12. Okay, so their reproductive phase begins in female. The reproductive phase begins at 10 to 12 years, and most probably it lasts till 45 to 50 years. Okay, 45 to 50 years. Okay, so it starts at the age of 10 to 12 years and lasts till 45 to 50 years. Okay, so once the females get mature, as we know, the ovaries are also getting mature. One of the ovaries started to release the egg. Okay, at the same time, the uterus becomes so much thick. And why it is so much thick? Because once the ovary releases the eggs into the fallopian tube, if it will get fertilized, then what will happen? It will get converted into the zygote, then embryo, and then that embryo get embedded into the ovary, and then it gets started to get developed, and that only we are calling as what? Pregnancy. Okay, but what happens if the eggs will not get fertilized? Okay, if the eggs will not get fertilized, then that eggs and the thickened wall of the uterus, or the thickening wall of the uterus, are get shed off in the form of the blood and the muscles, and they comes out from the female's body, and that only called as what? Menstruation. That phase is only called as what? Menstruation. Okay, so this menstruation is occurs within the month, or their period of the menstruation is what? Occurs at 28 to 30 days. Okay, 28 to 30 days. Within the 28 to 30 days, this same process takes place again, and again the blood and the blood vessels and the muscles comes out through the vagina, and that only called as what? Menstruation. Okay, so the first menstruation flow takes place in the female, then that first menstruation flow is called as what? Menarche. That first menstruation flow is called as menarche. Okay, so once it gets started, initially it becomes what? Irregular. Okay, it will take some time to become a regular. And next one is that this menstruation remains into the female up till the age, or at the age of the 45 to 50. Okay, 45 to 50. Okay, and after that stop, the menstruation flow gets stopped, or that menstrual cycle gets stopped. Okay, So that stopping of the menstruation cycle is only called as what? Menopause. That is called as what? Menopause. Okay. So two concepts are there, very important. So the first menstrual flow in the female, it is called as what? Menarche. While the stopping of the menstrual cycle at the age of the 45 to 50, that stopping menstrual cycle is called as what? Menopause. Okay. So at the 45 to 50, the MC, that is only what? Menstrual cycle stops, and that is only called as what? Menopause. Okay. So see here, once in the 28 to 30 days, one of the ovary releases the egg. If it get fertilized, then the further development takes place and it get embedded into the uterus, and there the it will started to grow. For that we are calling as what? Pregnancy. But if this process doesn't happen, then what happen? The egg, and along with the egg, the thickened wall of the ovaries, okay, it comes out in the form of the blood and the muscles, and that only we are calling as what? Menstruation. That menstruation occurs within the month, that is in the 28 to 30. The cycles is of the 28 to 30 days, okay. So within that 28 to 30 days, this process is happen. If the egg gets fertilized, then woman become pregnant. And if the egg doesn't get fertilized, then that eggs and the blood vessels throw out from the body in the form of menstruation. And that menstruation cycle occurs, that is 28 to 30 days. So this menstruation cycle occurs once in a 28 to 30 days. This menstrual cycle is also get controlled by the hormones. Okay, so as we know, all these changes are controlled by the hormones. Okay, so this is all about today. Today we have discussed about the hormones, target side. Also we have discussed about the productive phase of life in man, human beings. Also we have discussed two new concepts, that is what? Menstruation, menarche, and the menopause. Okay, so this is all about today. Today we will stop here. We will meet in the next video with the next point, and for today, thank you.